So let's see what the date is on this Canon Pixma MX310.
Huh. December 10th, 2007.
I guess it's time to unbox this freaking thing. Yes, it's true. I buy things. Sometimes they stay in the box for a very long time. 15 years later, I'm taking that freaking printer out of the box. Because basically, the specs on that printer are, and I don't mean dust, are better than the specs, which I probably do mean dust, on the HP printer. So, here's the gig. Here's the video. Let's take this Canon Pixma that's been rotting in the box for 15 years and see if it works. Let's see if the ink is dried up like Rosie O'Donnell's. I'm not even going to say it. I'm deploying the official Alfred.tv shiv. Nice. And there it is, resting comfortably in the box for 15 years like a freaking sarcophagus. And speaking seriously for a brief moment, and I'm doing this video despite the vocal strain. Speaking seriously for a brief moment, I didn't really need to repeat that. It hurts to talk right now. But with the printer being 15 years old, I would assume I can buy the ink fairly cheap. Then again, maybe not. But be that as it may, let me see if the Mac running Mojave even has a driver that's going to recognize that piece of shit. I will say that the build quality on this 15-year-old printer is actually pretty damn good. And what's the key element here? Here you go. The ink cartridges. And from something I had read, someone had done an analysis that based on weight, the ink costs more per ounce than gold. So, wow. Listen, the way to go is either a color laser printer or one of those ink tank printers. But yeah, there you go. And there's a shot of the device. Okay, and for the people that are into that peel fetish, I'm going to remove the condom. Oh yeah. I think there's like a whole Reddit group dedicated to this. Oh my, whatever. All right, all the condoms are off. Check it out, it comes with a phone cable for sending a fax. Yeah, so let's power this thing up. What the hell's a power button? There we go, 15-year-old printer, first boost. It's alive. But the real test, will it print? And the real test is there a driver for this thing? All right, it wants the ink cartridges, so let's open this thing up. Wow, look at that, there's a kickstand. And yeah, fine Alfred.tv cinematography. You probably can't see shit. All right, I'm now gonna break the seal, this 15-year seal on the black ink cartridge, ready? Oops. Let's try that again. Here we go. Holy shit. Nah, I just made that with my mouth. All right, the cartridges are in. Let's close this thing up. Look at that. It's like it's dampened. How lovely. All right, it's doing its ink setup now. I tell you, the software on this printer is probably saying, what the F? It's old. All right, so the instruction manual is referencing Mac OS 10 10.4. And there's a picture of the Mac cheese grater with an Apple whatever cinema display, whatever the hell that thing was called back in the day. And one caveat on this printer, There's no wireless. Oh well. Well, this is funny. Canon, you cheap bastards. There's no wireless, and you didn't include a freaking USB cable. There's no fucking cable. Oh yes, taking another dig through the box, I did find a robust manual. And to the younger viewers, what the hell is this? Oh, it's a CD-ROM. All right, I did find a spare cable kicking around, and yes, I framed this shot to get the 20th anniversary Macintosh obnoxiously in the frame. Now, there's no wireless, my computer is a good distance, so either I gotta get a really long extension cord, or I'm gonna plug this thing into the back of the Apple time capsule with a USB port, and let's see if we can get the driver working. That's the first step. Oh, a slow pan, Alfred.tv slow pan shot. Yes, I've been upgrading equipment and my network, and my longtime viewers are very happy that I'm now on Communist Cast Xfinity, so I have higher speeds and better upload speeds for those fine live streams, those webcasts. I gotta pull out a USB drive. I'm gonna plug the printer directly into that. Oh my god, something useful, but really useful if we can get the printer working. And the next step will be to see if I can put a hub in there. I mean, in theory, it should be able to work, so I can still have the backup time machine backup drive and the printer. So let's plug the printer directly into that Apple device. But these things are great. Sorry that Apple doesn't make them anymore. All right, for the people that don't know me or don't normally watch the crappy videos on my channel, if you think you're going to get proper screen capture with ScreenFlow, it's not gonna happen. Old school, gonna point the camera at the screen. Let's hit that plus sign, see if it finds the freaking printer. Dymo label, turbo. No, that's already in there. Ah, shit. I knew this was gonna be a problem. Might have to go to like some Gimp-Print. Well, in back of the Apple time capsule, a total fail. Now, I did find a 15 meter or a 15 foot, I don't know the difference, USB cable, printer cable, and guess what? Let's not use ScreenFlow. Holy crap, it does indeed recognize the printer as well as the fax machine. So let's press buttons. Well, like many of my technology videos, I am indeed in error. It just recognized the printer, but down below it says, software for this printer isn't available from Apple. Contact the printer's manufacturer for the latest software. So, yeah. Not going to work very cleanly, is it? All right, I'm going to give this Gimp-Print, Gutenprint a try. Ah, hell. Before I install that software, I just kicked off a time machine backup just in case it tanks my entire system. And I'm running 10.14 Mojave, or as we call it, Blojave. Now, I am going to do a future video on my backup strategy, but in addition to that 28 terabyte time machine volume used to cover my ass on that 40 terabyte RAID array, which has 15 terabytes of active storage, I do use this OWC. I call it a toaster, drive toaster, or they call it, like, I think, a dock or whatever. But I also use an app called Super Duper, and I clone my boot drive to one of those drives. So no ScreenFlow, but there's a Super Duper doing its thing. Yes, the old Thunderbolt displays, they still work just lovely on my trash can. Oh, and so many of you have commented on my dock. Look at how much shit I have in the dock. So, you know, usually people ask, what's in the dock? I say, my boat. No, I don't have a boat, but a lot of apps. And I'm probably going to do one of those obnoxious videos on my top 34 Mac apps, you know, whatever. And imagine doing that type of video showing software without using any ScreenFlow. By my own admission, I did something sketchy. Instead of downloading that 64-bit Guten whatever driver, I went to the Canon website and I downloaded a stinky old Mavericks driver, which is 32-bit. Let's see if it works though, because I'm running Mojave, so doesn't matter. I can run 32-bit stuff. All right, folks, you're seeing this as I'm doing it, not using ScreenFlow. Let's go to printers and scanners, and let's hit that little plus button, and let's hit that Canon MX310. Yes, it found the driver. Add. All right, let's see if I can print something. All right, I'm now gonna print that letter that went with the Steve Jobs business card. When I say card, like I'm from freaking Boston. Card, auction. Let's see if it prints. Wow, the diagnostic panel says wait momentarily. listen, this printer might wind up in the dumpster tonight. Open paper out tray. Okay, well that makes sense. Where the hell is that? Let me open this fucking thing. Ah, okay. Printing. There we go. That was pretty quick. I like doing the whole table shaking. Now you would think I would use image stabilization. Oh, hell no. All right, well, I gotta say, the color ink is good. Overall, pretty good for an old stinker. I think this is better than the HP. Now, I gotta install that driver for the scanner. That's important. But yeah, the official Canon driver, 32-bit Mavericks, went in with a warning on Mojave, but it did indeed print. Nice. So now that I've technically polluted this system with 32-bit drivers, let's continue doing sketchy shit and let me put in the 32-bit scanner driver and see if we can get the thing to scan. Well, I loaded in the scanner driver, but it needs this MP Navigator EX app. So yes, I loaded in this CD-ROM because I did put a USB Blu-ray burner on my trash can Mac Pro, so no problem. Look, I'm really polluting this very stable production system with these old-ass 32-bit apps. Oh, what the hell? I do it for you all. Oh, those old-school fonts and buttons. Unfortunately, I can't click on the yes button. It doesn't work. So if I can't get the scanner to work, this is a no-go. Dang it. All right, a few Google searches and I found a support page, Canon Canada, and they actually had MP Navigator EX for Mojave. Let's see if it activates the scanner. Oh, but first, let me eject that disk. There it is, disk ejection. Damn, it installed and ran, but doesn't know my model printer. All right, here's a great program, App Cleaner. Let's drag that MP Navigator and just remove that. And let's get rid of this. Done. All right, I'm going third party, gonna try VueScan. Oh wow, this is nice. VueScan absolutely acknowledged the scanner. I put something in the bed, let's do a preview. And here we go. This will solve the scanning problem. I put a book in there. Beautiful. And obviously I never read this book. It's, you know, upside down, but how to shoot videos that doesn't suck. While I'm doing another scan, I found actually this, recently found this, a photo of my mother at 18 years of age. So this picture is from 1938. I am going to scan this in as a TIFF. And overall, I got to say, all good. So indeed, a few sketchy things were done. I polluted my system with some old 32-bit drivers, but they seem to work. The scanner driver and scanner app from Canon, couldn't get that to work. But this VueScan, I'm gonna buy it. This is good. And if you think this 15-year-old printer is old, I got another one that's 21 years old. It's a dye sublimation printer. I'll be unboxing that one next. More to come. Mordecai! Actually, the way my voice sounds right now. Stay tuned. I found a freaking Next shirt. This is worth like billions. I love it.
Welcome to Alfred.TV.